Last week, I shared with you 5 of my predictions for the next 10 years of the Flow Arts, but there was too much stuff to cram into just one video. This week, I'm going to finish up the list by sharing with you my top 5 predictions for the coming 10 years, and believe me, it's going to get a lot more interesting this time around. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and Flow Arts to benefit your body and brain, and today, I'm sharing my top 10 predictions for the next 10 years of the Flow Arts by bringing it home with my top 5. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spin Balls, and Ultra Poi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. And a special thanks to the first non-business friend of the channel, Johnny Howard. Thanks so much for your support, Johnny. When last we left our intrepid adventurer, he made some pretty safe bets, making predictions based upon trends that are already evident in flow arts and wider culture. In this video, I'm going to be making some more fanciful predictions. Some of these are things that I personally would like to see happen, and some of them are wouldn't-that-be-awesome things that have occurred to me but that I don't have a lot of data to support. So where will these fanciful predictions lead us? Let's dive in. Prediction number 5. The first professional flow arts competition will happen in the United States. Now, there's already been competitions abroad. Again, see Russia for an example. But there's been a huge amount of resistance to them occurring in anything other than small and improvised formats here in the United States. I'm almost positive that's going to change. For one thing, as fire festivals decline in influence, as I outlined in my last video, we're going to need something else to become a center point of face-to-face contact in the flow arts world. Right now, a lot of that happens at music festivals, but with the electronic music market on the decline and post-COVID concerns about events of that scale, I think we're going to turn to smaller in-person events, and competitions seem like a really good fit for that. How will we know when we've gotten there? Well, there will be money for prizes instead of just props, winners will be featured more heavily in event promotions and media, and most importantly, there will be competitions that feed into each other. A Midwest champion will face off against a New England champion. Won't that be something? Will these competitions take off and become popular? It's hard to say, but I'm pretty sure we'll see them at least attempted in the next decade. Prediction number 4, flow arts will separate from circus again. I will fully admit that part of this is my bias speaking, but here's the thing. I can remember a time in this scene before there was a huge onus on merging flow arts with circus, or even, God forbid, before the whole weird attempts to retcon flow arts as having been circus all along. And a lot of folks forget that the roots of flow arts culture here in the United States had nothing to do with circus. It came out of transformational events like Burning Man and later on became a huge part of rave culture. That all changed roughly a decade ago when several European spinners made the festival circuit here in the United States, and a large number of American flow artists made the trek to EJC in France. Everybody came back wanting to make flow arts a part of circus. They wanted to see the kind of acceptance that circus enjoys in Europe become a part of flow arts culture here in the United States. They wanted poi spinners to make the top 40 jugglers list. They wanted popular jugglers to embrace poi as a prop and signal to other jugglers that poi was no longer considered the backwater of object manipulation. And well, it just wasn't terribly effective. We got one poi spinner on the top 40 list one year, but other than that, we really didn't get that much improvement to our visibility or considerations of our artistic merit on this side of the pond. The only people we got to take us more seriously was us ourselves, and it had the result of making the community more insular and less welcoming to newbies. Flow arts is actually kind of a perfect fit for the social media era in that everything that traditional circus and juggling types dislike about it, that its barrier to entry is low and it's possible to do something that looks really cool with it with minimal practice, is actually a feature and not a bug in the Instagram age. We've switched over to a culture now where it's all about people getting to participate and experience a thing for themselves. Because poi spinning, hooping, and staff spinning are all fairly easy to grasp the basics of, they're things that lots of people can embrace and do casually, show their friends in their backyards and on their Instagram feeds in between photos of food and their pets. And circus? Well, we see it pop up not infrequently on reality talent shows like America's Got Talent, but traditional media is really losing viewership and influence quickly, to say nothing of the fact that Cirque du Soleil, Ringling Brothers, and Big Apple Circus have all declared bankruptcy in the past 5 years. Like all forms of live entertainment, like theater, dance, and music, attendance has been declining for these shows, and the trend line shows no signs of reversing. I think at some point we're going to realize there's just not that much to gain by asking for a seat on a sinking ship. Whereas the opportunities afforded by being a nimble and accessible art form in the social media era are many, I think the attempt to merge the two will be seen in retrospect as a hiccup in the history of this art form. God, I can't wait for the comments on this one. Prediction number 3, flow arts will have a new renaissance in VR. Okay, now straight up, this is wishful thinking, but stick with me. Facebook has basically signaled that at this point, it considers VR to be its life raft. The kinds of interactions that it facilitates are going to become less and less desirable as its brand becomes tarnished and its audience ages. So what's the new sexy thing they'll introduce to keep themselves relevant? Well, right now, Instagram is doing an amazing job of keeping the company afloat, and I think it will continue to do so. I'm actually really impressed by how many different apps Instagram competes with and how good a job it does in this regard. But between its acquisition of Oculus and recent talk of creating a virtual metaverse for online interaction, which, yes, I've read Snow Crash too. We all know how this ends. It seems that Facebook is still betting hard on VR, but VR has a huge problem. The technology is expensive, and it's not great just yet. One of the biggest problems with VR is what's called haptic feedback. That is, creating devices that can simulate interactions with real-world objects. But there are objects that will provide their own feedback and make for perfect use cases in the virtual world. Flow arts props. A company called Lanternsmith is already hard at work on this, creating props that can send signals to a computer to track their props in 3D space. Their products aim to not just take flow arts into the virtual world, but also gamify it in ways that we've never seen before. This one is admittedly a bit of a stretch, because demand for GPUs for cryptocurrency mining is kind of strangling the VR industry in the cradle right now. But if they can be manufactured at volume and prices come down enough for them to become as ubiquitous in people's homes as, say, video game consoles are now, yeah, I think we might be looking at a renaissance for flow arts and, as well, opening up for an entirely different audience. Prediction number 2, a boom in 3D printing leads to a second wave of flow arts small businesses. 10 years ago, there was a watershed moment in the flow arts. Contact Poi became the in-vogue form factor for Poi and eventually the default for it. This opened the door for dozens upon dozens of small shops to open up selling contact poi because the materials were so easy to acquire and the manufacturing for them is comparatively simple. A huge impact on this was that the tide of manufacturers turned away from companies with a handful of employees and the capital to invest in things like LED or fire props, and switched over to being influencer-driven. Suddenly, anybody with a YouTube or Instagram following could sell their own poi. This tide didn't last, though. Many people who opened up these small shops weren't terribly good at running a business, and before long, the bigger manufacturers had effectively gobbled up the bottom end of that market. But it was an interesting moment, and I like to think we could get another one like it. 3D printers have been getting smaller and cheaper now for years. They're still mainly thought of as something that only nerds or makers play with, but I'd be willing to bet that if the price on them drops below, say, $100 for an entry-level unit, we'll see them become a lot more popular. And when that happens, one of two things almost certainly will come out of it. Possibility number one, there will once again be an explosion on the number of living room-based prop manufacturers, 3D printing unique designs and selling them through online shops like Etsy. Or it's possible there won't even be a process anymore of manufacturing and shipping props. Instead, you'll purchase a CAD file from designers and print their props out for yourself at home. That'll mean we get a generation of computer-savvy flow artists who will come up with increasingly creative ways to print out a wide variety of props in a lot of different form factors. Want to rapid prototype several different fans' designs? Sure thing. Want a special set of poi for your convention cosplay? Hire a designer to turn around a custom file for you. The possibilities here are endless. And prediction number one, I will still be poi dancing. So real talk, I'm 41 as I'm recording this video, and I'm very conscious of the fact that the human body starts doing some real weird things as it ages. I'd like to still be spinning in a decade. I'd like to still be making videos in a decade. So let's call this last item my prayer that it comes to fruition, and that in 10 years, we'll all be watching me, perhaps a little bit grayer, breaking down whatever wisdom I've managed to accrue in that time on my channels. So there you go, my 10 predictions for 10 things that'll happen in the next decade of the flow arts. The quickest way to be wrong is to make a prediction. So I look forward to revisiting this list in 2031 and laughing at both what I got right and what I got wrong. Here's hoping you are there laughing along with me. What did you think of my predictions? Do you have any of your own? Leave me a comment and keep the conversation going by sharing this video and subscribing to my channel so you know exactly when I drop a new video and to help my channel grow. Real quick, I also just wanted to throw out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind support of these wonderful people right here. These are my Flow patrons over on Patreon, and they, along with the people listed down in the description, helped to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. Do you like Poi content? Do you like tutorials, flow sessions, and vlogs on flow arts culture? Consider signing up to support my work. I want to bring flow arts to the wider world and help people connect with their brains and their bodies through prop spinning. So help me do it. Head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. Not only will you be supporting that mission, but you'll also be able to get early access to all of my content, a vote in what content I produce in the future, and a host of other awesome rewards, such as getting a special weekly poi lesson delivered to your inbox that is only available to my supporters. Go give that a look and please consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you in advance. So what do you think I got right? And what do you think I got wrong? Leave me your comments and let me know. I'd love to hear your thoughts. In the meantime, I'll leave a link to a playlist of some other flow arts vlogs that I've done down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching this video on YouTube. Be sure to get outside to flow today, and I'll see you with a new video on Wednesday. Peace.